It's rare that Dave Hopley closes his bakery and restaurant during a snowstorm, but this was no ordinary storm.
But nobody had any inclination it was going to be a week later before we'd open the doors.
Having taken a big hit to his bottom line, Hopley's hoping to make up some business when he opens tomorrow.
Earlier, we had our kitchen staff in doing all the prep work, chopping and slicing and dicing and baking off.
Recovery will take time. There is still a lot of snow to remove. Buses will go back on the streets, but getting on one could prove difficult.
Downtown is, you know, it's the heartbeat of St. John's, so it'll be nice to see it back alive again.
What's that going to be called? What
is it? Brenda O'Reilly is also ramping up for tomorrow's opening.
We've got, you know, the place getting cleaned up. We've got places being shoveled out, all of our emergency exits and all that. And, of course, the chefs are in, you know, prepping and planning.
There's beer to be brewed, food to prepare. Sadly, a lot of O'Reilly's stock had to be dumped.
We did have perishable stuff that had to go in the garbage, and any of the fresh protein that, you know, couldn't last, so that had to go in the garbage.
Many business owners feel they shouldn't have been forced to close for so long, had the city just banned cars, not pedestrians.
We have all these restaurants and stores, restaurants especially downtown, whose food was rotting away, and people were trying to get food.
To help out, the Board of Trade is encouraging people to get out and support local businesses.
You might get a bump this week because Newfoundlanders are good people and they will come out and support small business.
If people have a favorite restaurant or a favorite store downtown, I think now would be a good time to come and patronize them.
After the toughest week they have ever endured, finally the end is in sight. Chris O'Neill Yates, CBC News, St. John's.